All righty. It's time for some more basketball. Lions Nation and Aggie Nation, really. I'm sure there's many OPSU Aggies tuning in to tonight's broadcast to cheer on your team in the away status at this point. And this is going to be an exciting night. It's the second to the last game of the conference. So we're whittling our way down to postseason play when it's kind of one and done. And it's so exciting when you get into that mode. And right now, as it stands, it's been a pretty tough year for OPSU. And if you didn't see the women's game, we talked about this a little bit, but OPSU is in a rebuilding season. And two new coaches coming in and doing a great job with the hand that they've been dealt. Yep. And building something for the future. And it's going to be exciting to see OPSU come back up. They are sitting right now in conference 2-18. So it's been a long, tough year, but I'm sure at this point you're just trying to add to the learning experience. And then on the other side of the coin, you got Coach Deal with a very nice run this year, probably not working out to exactly how we would have drawn it up, but very respectable 18-8, definitely in the top 50 or 40 in the nation of schools, and very strong potential to get invite to go to the national tournament. I mean, you got to win out here, and definitely starts with the night. Make sure you win this against OPSU, and then a tough one against Wayland Baptist, who will probably be earning some votes in the coaches' poll coming out next week. And and then you just got to do well in the tournament and, you know, get a good first round. So it looks right now like Sagu will finish fourth. There is a small chance that they could go finish in fifth. They'd have to lose both games, and then Science and Arts would have to get two big wins. But it's not likely. So the scenario puts Sagu in fourth place, and that means they will host the first round here in the Schaefer Center. And that's exciting because we always look forward to having another game to call for them. But another capstone on Delton Dill and his career here and the wonderful job he and his staff have done year after year after year.
Yeah.
And it's just exciting to have a great team of basketball players and people. And it makes campus life very exciting around here.
Yeah, he's built a great culture. He's got a great staff. He's an amazing coach. I mean, just the X's and O's, but the energy he brings, the pride in the game, the play the game the right way, and the players he's brought in, it really is. It's fun to be on campus.
All right, we're going to throw it down to the court side. They're going to honor Cortland Blake for his 1,000th point, and then the pregame festivities. You're watching Sagu Sports Network.
Cortland, your contribution to this team has been nothing short of extraordinary, and we are immensely proud to have you as a part of our family. Please join us in giving Cortland a well round of applause as we celebrate this significant accomplishment. Thank you, and let's make some noise for Cortland Blake. Southwestern Assemblies of God University welcomes all players, officials, and spectators to this contest featuring the Aggies of Oklahoma Panhandle State University and your Sagu Lions. As a member of the NAIA, we are committed to the true spirit of competition as champions of character, embracing five core values: respect, integrity, responsibility, servant leadership, and sportsmanship. We ask each of you as a participant, official, or spectator to abide by these values by creating a positive environment in which our athletes might participate, our officials may work, and you, the spectator, may enjoy. We hope you will enjoy this contest. At this time, we would ask everyone to stand, remove your hat as we honor God with an invocation. Then please remain standing as we honor our nation with the singing of the national anthem. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day you have given us. I pray for all these athletes that you protect them and keep them safe. And whether win or lose, we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Now the starting lineups for the Aggies. At guard, a 6'5 freshman out of Chicago, Illinois, number 2, Amari Brown. At guard, a 6'4 senior out of Lawton, Oklahoma, number 3, Joe Greaves. At guard, a 6'6 sophomore out of Loganville, Georgia, number 4, Abdul Diaby. At guard, a 6'5 redshirt freshman out of Columbia, Missouri, number 10, Taki Chivas. At forward, a 6'7 freshman out of Turks and Caicos, number 15, Sherlock Padmore II. The head coach of the Aggies is Charles Belt. Assistant coaches is Mackenzie Fessler. And now the starting lineup is for your Sagu Lions. At guard, a 5'9 junior out of Mansfield, Texas, number 1, Alaric Hall. At guard, a 6'2 junior out of Mansfield, Texas, number 2, CJ Hall. At guard, a 5'10 grad student out of Van Austin, Texas, number 3, Noah Bowling. At forward, a 6'6 sophomore out of Van Austin, Texas, number 5, J.J. Bowling. At forward, a 6'6 senior out of Fort Worth, Texas, number 23, Cortland Blake. The head coach for the Lions is Delton Deal. Assistant coaches are Manuel Doye, James Sutherland, Mitch McMullen, and Darian Davis. Grad assistant coach is Logan Edwards.
All right, there you have it, the starting lineups for both of these squads, and it is time to tip it off. Coming down to the end of conference play. This is the second to the last game, and both of these games are ending in the Schaefer Center. So that's very exciting for Lions Nation. And to round it off and get ready for the postseason tournament. It's kind of what it's all about and what
it
you
is.
Play for.
This is exactly what you play for. It doesn't get really much better than that. Going into conference play, and you just want a shot, right? You just want a shot to be able to keep playing one more game, and that's what the Lions are going to do. We'll kind of see where they finish up, but tonight they just need to take care of business here in the Chafee Center. You don't want to let this game get out of hand. You want to do what you need to do, get the win, and move on to the last game here in the Chafee Center. So looking forward to tonight's matchup. OPSU challenging. I know the record may not say it, but they're not just a cakewalk. Right? They're going to come here to play,
right.
And we got to be ready
Absolutely.
To play as
well. They play the game
nice.
To win.
Oh, that's a
great defense.
Sure
actually,
felt like that was a goaltend.
Well, I don't know if anybody actually got it. It just popped off the front of the rim really hard as C.J. Hall took it really hard to the goal, and bodies flying everywhere. And, we'll
Let's see.
Here.
Oh, no, that's the last
where it went
part.
Out.
That's where we're already past that. Alaric Hall, as he always does, tight defense up top. Good no call there. Oh, well.
He
traveled there.
So it was a no call.
It was a no call. Sherlock Padmore the second there with a little travel call. Sagui's going to take the ball out of bounds. Still no score here in the Chafee Center. Just underway. First half action. OPSU versus Sagui Lions here in the Chafee Center. Waxahachie, Texas. Glad to be with you guys tonight. Looking forward to some great competition.
And they're a little confused. So I think they're going to look at the replay and try to figure out who the ball went out on. Oh, no, they caught a travel.
They caught a travel.
But
the sideline ref.
Well, maybe one of the refs called the foul before the travel.
That's what I think it is on the baseline, the referee on the baseline. I thought was going to call a foul here, and it looked like the sideline took control there.
Yeah.
And, it looks like they're going to look at.
I mean, J.J. Bowling kind of he fell to the ground. I mean, you could go he flopped or it was a charge or a blocking foul. I didn't know that you could review whether a foul was a foul, though. So this is interesting. And and we're just going to have to wait to see. Maybe
not clear what they're looking at here.
Maybe did someone go out of bounds? I mean, the ball was in play. They called a treble. Oh, way back? Okay, we just got word that they're checking for the play before was a goaltending. Which,
two plays prior, right? That's just what I thought it was.
No, it was the series before.
The series before.
Yeah.
Which is what I thought it was.
Yep.
The ball was up over the rim.
Yep.
Already coming down, pinned
know.
Against the glass is what I thought.
Yeah, maybe after you guys show the ref what they need to see, show us what. So maybe we can see the replay. Okay, C.J. Hall goes up.
Yep, that's a goaltend.
Oh, did it hit the
glass?
It hit the glass.
That's right. Good call there.
Yeah, they do add the points there. Man, okay. So this is the can of worms that get opened up when NAI has really made a big effort to add what they call officials, the referees replay. And there are 17 reviewable items on that menu. And I, well, I think reviewing plays and trying to get it right, in the spirit of that's a good idea. But being able to go back, if you didn't catch it then, I don't think you should be allowed to review it. So if you didn't blow your whistle for it, it should be non-reviewable.
Well, I think the fact that they didn't score now.
But there was no whistle blown. like if there was a whistleblower and there was some controversy whether it was or wasn't, yeah, go and look and say. But nobody caught it. No whistleblown. There was no play stoppage. It was just a rebound and they come down. So this is what I'm saying. It's a little bit of Pandora's box. If we start going, you cross halftime and the referees go to the locker room and they say, hey, remember that play at within the first minute of the game? I wonder if that was a goaltend. And then they could come back out.
Oh, Cortland Blake.
Sorry.
Wow.
Actually, they waved it off. They waved the points off. They gave it to CJ. Then they waved it off.
You're right. They gave
him. How about that?
I thought it was weird that they actually let them take the ball to bounds. So that must. Oh man.
And that's 3 for 3, or a matching of threes between
number
OPSU.
Number three, Joe Greaves from the corner.
So I kind of agree with wiping out, even though it was a goaltend. We got to see, yes, that was a goaltend. A good effort by the referees to try to see what was going on. They ended up waving it off, back off. I just disagree with going back in time. And, like, where do you stop?
Oh, nice head and shoulders faked by CJ. Gets bumped on the follow through. No call there by the referee.
Good rebound by the Aggies.
Amory Brown, number 2. Oh, man, great quickness there by number 10.
Oh, great block by J.J. Bowling.
Unbelievable block there. And they're going to
Say that was a foul.
Foul on the shot.
Yep. Just kind of ran through it and caught too much of the shooter. Now C.J. Hall gets to go to the free throw line, try to get those 2 points the easy way. Gets the first one. Got a new wardrobe addition for C.J.
Yeah, it took me a little off.
He's going old school tonight with the headband.
Headband?
Like it.
I do. I like it a lot. Able to get that second one to go as well. Sagu up too early in the first half. Tight defense by the Lions, as always.
Nice ball movement by OPSU. Oh, way up, skied to get that, and didn't get the tip somehow. Blake,
woo,
bottoms. That's 2 for 2 for Cortland Blake.
Right in stride, transition three. And some, take that every time.
Some people say that Cortland Blake shouldn't be called a three guard because he plays five, at least on defense, but guy that can shoot the lights out from the three side of the floor like that. I have no problem calling him a three guard.
Joe Greaves able to knock that three down for the Aggies. He's having a good start early for the Aggies.
Blake kept that one alive. And that one's a little long from three, so now he's 2 for 3.
Noah Bowling trying to cut off number 2 there, Amory Brown.
Bowling with another rebound. I should say J.J. Bowling.
Good. Down on the block. Cortland.
Oh, that's pretty. That is pretty.
Fade away. Good find in the short corner there by Cortland Blake to C.J. Hall. Able to knock that down. Really, really pretty play right there.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, man.
Great cut.
Abdul Diaby with the finish there right off the glass. Just a nice little tap. Good cut. Great pass. Tight game here early.
That was way off by Noah Bowling.
Good cut off there. Nice defense. Oh, good find. Oh, what another block by Cortland Blake. Can't block it a second time.
That's Padmore.
Oh, Blair Call with a switch there, trying to take advantage of the big guy. Noah Bowling with a nice hustle play.
Very nice move. Stuck with it. Just a couple little dribbles, and that's what happens when you get the mismatch. The two guard that's very capable of making slashing type moves with the ball, and you got the big on you. It's actually a mismatch for the big.
Padmore down the block, working Blake.
Ooh, almost a steal by C.J. Hall.
Number 24 into the game for the Aggies, Boston Douglas. Also number zero, Bison Miller, into the game for the Aggies as well.
That's nice.
Nice little pull up.
Man, he hung up in the air for quite a while.
Brown. Getting hot. Above. Great elevation there. A little.
Tried to dunk
it.
He did try. It just popped out. I mean, he was right there. And they're going to get
the push off.
Yeah.
That's the right call there.
Number 10, Chivas, for pushing off. It was a good rebound. Great effort. I love the effort. And come in, you know, 2-18, and the Aggies not showing any, like, cowering at all. Like, we're not going to kiss the ring.
Nope.
Oh, Corlett Blake, 3-for-4.
He's on fire early.
Shoots 52% from three-point line. Prolific would be an understatement.
Good pressure there.
Jeeves gets it. Goes up.
Oh, man. Somehow. Somehow was able to get that ball in the hole. Sagu right back. Running the floor quick. Larry Call around the horn. Noah with a little pump fake. Larry Call, nice little teardrop in the middle.
The teardrop. Larry Call.
See that a lot nowadays, but that's a really underrated shot for that quick point guard like that.
It is, and I'm gonna just tell you, it's hard. Like it's hard. I mean, he's the smallest guy on the floor, and you know, of course, he's the fastest guy on the floor, so he blows by the first layer of defense. But then you, when you blow by the first layer, you got all the bigs to contend with, and that's why you know, kind of an underrated shot. Yep. You got to have it, though. You got to be able to pull that tool out of your bag, and it's just difficult. So I out of a 0 to 10 scale of difficulty, I call that an 8.
It is when you're as fast as him as well, the control that it requires, and to get that ball airborne quick and with the right amount of touch. Yeah, I would agree with you. Very difficult shot. Looks easy on TV, but definitely not as easy in person to make that happen. But Alaric Hall certainly has the skill to do that, and he pulled out right there.
They made a substitution without that's just kind of funny. Well, all right, so Chivas thought the substitution came in for him because maybe that's what was said, and then the whoever subbed didn't come back out of the timeout. So they're like, hey, you guys only got four players on the floor.
Nice hands there by Noah Bowling. Brown able to get it back and knock it down. Wow, what concentration there by Brown. Able to gather himself.
That's two really good shots by Brown from that range. Good block. Cortland Blake doing Cortland Blake things.
With it.
You might get him once, but it's very hard to get him twice.
Big body, man. He's 75% shooting 3-for-4 from downtown. And also working hard down there on the block to get those little chippers in. Oh, man, nice shot. Chivas.
Glad he came back in the game now.
Yeah, that paid off for the Aggies. Downtown, Cortland Blake ceiling. And a nice little, man, they just do not have an answer for Blake tonight.
We've often asked this question. Who does?
Yeah. for a big guy. He's got the quickness of a three, but the body of a 4 or 5, and yep. he can knock it down from downtown, but he can also work you down low. Just an all-around amazing player.
Should be first team all-conference. Here comes Noah Bowling. Just waiting for a squad. Get it down to J.J. Bowling. His brother Noah looking. Gets it to Cortland Blake. He fires from three. Make that 4 for 5, ladies and gentlemen. Shooting 80% in this first half from the three-point line for Cortland wow. Blake.
Great hands by C.J. Hall. Brown up top. Out to Miller.
That one's long. Five for six.
Well.
And you're going to get the old Michael Jordan shrug like, I don't know, guys. It's just my night. It's just my night.
Wow. That's fun to watch. Fun to watch.
In the first quarter of this game, that one's long.
Long by number three, Greaves.
Of the 27 points Sagu has scored, Cortland Blake has 19 of them. Wow.
Coach Deal going to the bench a little bit, giving players some breather. Got number 24 Yonker into the game. Also number 13, Justin Collins in the game for the Lions.
And he's the big point guard, the anomaly to this team.
Oh, man.
And there's C.J. Hall now getting in the three-point yeah. action. And let's see. That's – oh, what is the total team shooting from the three? Well, this is crazy. Oh,
Jones,
man,
comes
a lot,
with
a lot
his
of threes falling tonight,
three.
Even for the Aggies.
Yeah.
Trace Bowling, his turn. No.
Oh, nice
and
rebound.
Just being in the right place, C.J. Hall gets the tip back. Don't go back to 11 in these games, but played 21 with C.J. Hall. He's going to send you back to 11 a lot. That's an analogy for the players out there.
Off left.
Oh, that's a nice move.
Zero. Miller. That was a good move. Good rebound.
Padmore gets another two. This is just an offensive back and forth game.
Nice handles by Hall, pulling it back out. Kind of reset a little bit here. Screen by Yonker, rolling to the bucket. Oh, nice fill by Trace. Couldn't get that to go, but filled that vacated spot that Yonker went to the glass. Trace filled a nice opening there. Couldn't quite get the ball, but that's a really nice play there. Nice action, second, third option on that play.
Trapped down on the line, and they're going to say Noah Yonker fouled him.
Foul call number 24, Noah Yonker. That's his first personal, first team foul. Now the line of TV2, number 4, Abdul Yonker.
That one goes in. He's got one more coming.
Back into the game for the Lions.
I mean, the Aggies really still right there. It's only a chance to make it six, and that's after a 7 of 9 shooting from three-point line by Sagu, and you're only down six. Wow, talking about weathering the storm.
Yes.
That's impressive.
With that kind of percentage by Sagu, you would expect 10, 12, 15-point lead.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, it's only six. Yeah, and if you're OPSU,
that's 21 points from the three from range. So that's hard to keep up with.
Yeah.
Man.
If you're in their huddle, you're in the Aggie huddle right now, and you're saying, guys, we're still in this after an onslaught of threes, and we are well-positioned still with that and still have a really good chance.
Yep. Okay, so it's 6 for 10. Something's wrong with that. Let's see, 4, 6. Yeah, okay, 6 for 10. I don't remember 4 being missed. So,
Justin Collins to bring the ball up for the floor for the Lions.
Oh, they're going to say he goes the other way.
Yep.
They got Yonker moving through. I think they think he pushed. I don't know if we'll see the replay, but anyway, he's in the books with his second foul now.
Jones still with the ball, pressured by Collins. No PSU. Still very much in this game. Midway through the first half.
Tapped. So that's going to go in the books as a block for
Collins. Nice.
Woo!
Nice.
What a dime.
Fine. Nice find by C.J. Hall to J.J. Bowling.
Beautiful. Bowling.
And uses his head.
Hey,
still
any
there.
Way you can get it done. Anyway.
CJ loses the handle.
They're going to call the foul because it was a reach around from Diaby. So that's going to take Yonker out, bring back in Blake, and another big Kylan Owens in the number 21 white jersey. So probably as big a five that Coach Dill can field at one time right now. Oh, that is beautiful.
Nice hang time.
Collins.
There. Collins with a strong rebound.
Well, that's Kylan Owens gets the rebound. Collins took it up and hung up in the air. Just that shot, that's kind of that teardrop shot. Are so much finesse.
A lot of hang time there, too. Yeah, really impressive.
His elevation is very impressive.
Deflected out by the Aggies. Sagu Lions still going to maintain possession here. 20 seconds on the shot clock. And just over 7 minutes to go in the first half. Sagu up just by a little bit, 34-26 over OPSU. Blake back to Trace. And they're going to say nope. 3 seconds in the lane there.
One. It's a little slow motion, so you can't. Yeah, look at the clock. I don't know, man.
Yeah,
it was close. It was close.
It was close.
Nice tip away from Justin Collins. That should be Sagu's ball. It is.
Here we get. Collins has his choice of which screen to go with. Goes left side there, off the glass. Ooh, nice take.
Man, he just gives you another dimension for scoring. And to be able to have a point guard of that size, but yet attack like a two guard, that's just going to be nice in the future.
Well, he also had the option. He took it there. Also had the option of the screener rolling down to the bucket. So he had another scoring option there, too. Great play there. Made the right decision to take it all the way to the rim. Was rewarded with the easy basket. Breeze off the mark.
Here comes Collins. Again, maybe forcing the issue just a little bit. As he grows in the game, he'll understand maybe backing it out. Unless you're just going to go hard and maybe go right to the rack, backing it out, it's not a bad alternative option. Yep.
Going to send Diaby to the line.
Oh, I think they call it on the ground.
Call it on the floor. Back to Diaby. Going to baseline.
Taking it straight to Cortland Blake. They're going to say that is on J.J. Bowling. No. I take that back. And they're going to say that was on Douglas. In and out.
Oh, nice hands.
Great
there.
Hands.
Oh, got him just a little bit on the reach.
On. So I think they actually caught it on three, which is Greaves. And that puts Colin Owens, the transfer from San Angelo State. Angelo State, I think they call it now.
It's a deathly combination having those two big guys out on the floor.
Yep.
And especially Blake, as hot as he is from the perimeter, and you still have a big body down there to clean up the glass. Really, really good combination Coach Steele's going with.
Larry Hall is back in the game. Tried to get a steal there.
Blake all the way out to the three-point line.
And that's kind of what you want.
Yeah.
You want to bring him away from the bucket as much as possible.
Nice crossover there.
Yep, and that's going to be a foul.
Yep.
Diaby doing some big things in this game. And he's a good free throw shooter. So he's hit his first two. He'll get one more here. Oh, that one's short.
Just a little short. Eric Hall run on the floor for the Lions. Another transition offense.
Oh, that's smart play by Colin Owens. It's going to stay.
Nice heads-up play.
It's good cover-up. Great double team there. And just a really smart play by Colin Owens.
Portland handoff. Reset the offense here. Seven to shoot. Larry Hall on the drive. They're giving it up to Noah Bowling.
Yep. Brother combination there and the assist and points. Noah Bowling, you could just see he stepped into it and the rotation was perfect. Shot it with ease.
Wonder how many times in the backyard they practiced that one.
Or they shot it against each other.
Yeah, definitely good chemistry there. It's almost like you can read the other person's mind
when you grow up and
play ball together that much. And what a privilege it is. Watch both of them on the floor at the same time. Oh, man, nice.
C.J. Hall. Acting like a veteran down there, give him the shimmy with the shoulder and the fadeaway, looking like Larry Bird.
Yeah, I'll be setting the screen. Gets the ball back up top. Guarded by Blake. Nice pressure. Well, really, Cortland Blake forced him into a really tough shot. Nice defensive sequence there by Cortland Blake.
Reset the clock back to 20. One referee is going to disagree with resetting the clock back to 20. And
it's going to be overruled.
So, yeah. And Coach Dill's like, why would we reset the clock? I kind of got to ask the same question. It was just a dead ball. Chivas.
Oh, man. Yep. Yep, good call there.
It's a bump.
Yeah, call on Chivas there.
Yeah, I mean, it.
Just too much contact there, a little shoving.
Well, he went down into pick position, so that's an illegal pick because he was moving into. If he'd have just held his hands up real high, it would look like an incidental collision.
Leg to the right hand.
Wow.
Can't stop that.
Wow.
Little jump hook there. No way to stop that.
Good tip away by CJ Hall.
Good heads up there.
It's been a little while for OPSU to get a good bucket. They've gotten some good shots.
Brown off the top of the backboard.
Just not falling. That was not one of them.
Brown on the ball screen, rolling to the bucket. Back to Hall. Off right.
And there.
Pretty easy rebound.
J.J. Bowling gets it back. He says, I'm going to dunk it two-handed time with this time. Make sure it goes in.
Nice little double team. Force the ball back out to the perimeter. Blake on the defense on the block. Yeah, got him.
We're going to get Cortland Blake with the foul there. Which will be his first foul.
Yeah, I'll be back to the line. He's
yeah, he's prolific
being aggressive
down there.
Yeah, yep. Been aggressive, taking the ball to the hole, drawing contact, and
that is his game.
Yeah, good free throw shooter. Clock stop, able to still score some points. 2 minutes left here in the first half. Sagu up 45-31. Yeah, I'll be able to knock that first one down. And able to get that one to go as well. Gets the Aggies within 12. CJ gonna pull the trigger. Oh, wow.
CJ Hall gets that one to go.
A little bit of acting job there. I thought he might draw a whistle as well, but didn't quite. Ref didn't believe it enough.
And Coach Belt was asking for the flop call.
Yeah. Oh, nice head and shoulders fake. It's going to be a 2-point just inside the line there. Number three, Greaves, able to knock that down. Long two. Portland Blake with a hustle, able to track that rebound down. Back out to CJ, now wants the ball down on the block. Noah's going to give it to him. A little quick dribble. Ah, still fighting?
Yeah. And that's just when, you know, there's no need to go for that gamble.
Yeah. Yeah, you weren't really going to.
There's no loose ball there, and just trying to get a quick squeeze. Yeah, you're going to end up fouling more than you actually get the tie up.
And OPSU will take the ball out on the baseline. Go to the length of the floor here. They're called with a little bit of pressure, just enough to make him think a little bit.
Yeah.
A little pesky.
Very bothersome.
Just, yeah. Like that fly you're just trying to swat. Like,
yeah.
Get away from me.
Yeah.
Yeah, got him on the arm there.
Got it going up. Got to be careful where your hands are.
Really had him in a – didn't really have to foul there. That was going to be a tough shot to make.
Yeah.
Kind of bailed him out a little there.
Yeah. Just keep your hands back and no need to even touch the player.
Yeah, I'll be able to, again, knock this free throw down. Gets him back within 12 and knocks the second one down. Under a minute to go here in the Schaefer Center. First half action. SAGU up 48-37 on the OPSU Aggies.
Nice.
Oh,
what
man.
A play. What a pass.
Great right pass. Blake able to find a little gap and a great pass on time, quick. Great finish there by Blake. Good pass. By Larrick Hall. And the Aggies going to be content here. 1.5 second difference between the shot and game clock.
Nice slip play.
Oh, good block.
Oh.
Oh, man.
Wow. At the buzzer. Are you kidding me? And actually,
Reeves.
You know, going in just down 11.
Wow.
You've weathered. Couple big shooting runs from SAGU. They put up 50 strong, 50 and a half. Like, that's some strong shooting. And you almost put up 40 yourself.
Yep.
So not terrible considering OPSU shooting great. 57. Oh, that's weird. 57 from the three-point line and 57 in your overall field goal percentage. Rebounding, OPSU doing a really good job on the boards.
I mean, they're hanging in there tough.
And there you go. You see all the split out of
Yeah, I'll be having a solid game.
Those that have scored or gotten on in the game or on the stat sheet in some way. Yeah, J.J. Bowling just doing what he does a lot, and that is get a lot of rebounds. He stays very active, tipping balls. They don't have a tipping stat, but if you could just track all the little intangible things that J.J. Bowling does, you would have a lot of stats on that sheet, because he, like a Larrick Hall, does it in your face. He's very bothersome. Well, J.J. Bowling is very bothersome in the paint. He just keeps balls alive somehow. There's no real stat for that. There's no way to track, you know, you didn't get the rebound, but you tipped it to the player who got the rebound. So he's having a really good half. And, of course, C.J. Hall and, man, Corlin Blake just lights out with their shooting hand. And that's what you need. You know, you can't – like, I think OPSU, you know, they say you better play your best game. You better play your best game. Or – we're going to be right there. And that's kind of what's happening right now. I mean, shooting 57% from the three-point line, it's playing your best game. And that's kind of been the difference if you really boil it all down. Storyline is perimeter shooting by SAGU has just been outstanding. All right, we're going to kick it to a couple words from our sponsor, but we'll be back shortly with the rest of this game, the second half.
It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, you're watching the SAGU Sports Network.
When I was looking for a college to attend, I didn't just want an education. I wanted an experience. When I found SAGU, I knew I'd found a university that thrives on strong faith and solid friendships. I feel at home in my classes. I can interact with my professors and classmates because instruction is personalized. With a diverse student body, I have plenty of chances to be myself while growing with amazing people at the same time. If you're looking for much more than a college education, SAGU is for you.
And with us cheering you on, there's no limit to where it can take you. Baylor Scott and White Health, the power to live better.
Trust someone with your money. You're part of something greater than yourself. You're investing in a principle that it takes individuals to create a community, that we are stronger when we support each other, that at some point, everyone will need a helping hand, that a meaningful purpose can be found in a calling. At AGC, we're banking with a purpose, so you can live for yours.
Your power is unstoppable. And with us cheering you on, there's no limit to where it can take you. Baylor Scott and White Health, the power to live better.
When you trust someone with your money, you're part of something greater than yourself. You're investing in a principle that it takes individuals to create a community, that we are stronger when we support each other, that at some point, everyone will need a helping hand, that a meaningful purpose can be found in a calling. At AGC, we're banking with a purpose, so you can live for yours.
Your power is unstoppable. And with us cheering you on, there's no limit to where it can take you. Baylor Scott and White Health, the power to live better.
Here we go. It starts here. 8-10. Take one.
Good. How are you?
Good.
Pretty good. Coach D, I did want to start with you.
Okay.
Why do you think student athletes come to SAGU?
Yeah, I mean, to showcase your talents in your sport, but I think SAGU uniquely gives you a family atmosphere, it gives you a community, it gives you a chance to grow your whole self, to your spiritual growth especially, to who you are as a man or who you are as a person, and I think that we offer a little bit deeper understanding of yourself whenever you leave, and I think that whenever they leave here, they really feel a part of something bigger than themselves.
What have you enjoyed most about being
feels like a family, and I wouldn't want to be anywhere else just because like how fun it is, and it's just been a really great experience.
I've never been in a place that is just loved on each other as much as the people do here at SAGU, and I think our guys feel it. I know I feel it as a coach.
The people, not just in basketball, but outside of basketball, are like so selfless and actually genuinely care about you.
It starts here.
I wanted to finish my degree, but I didn't know where to start. My faith and family are my priorities, and I didn't see a way I could go back to school. I barely have time for myself. How would I have time to go to class? I had all but given up until a friend told me about SAGU Online. They told me I could get credit for my life experience, save thousands of dollars, and graduate early. I took a leap of faith, and now I am set to finish my degree faster than I could have imagined. I take classes that fit my schedule, and I get to learn from amazing professors who have become my friends. The Bible-based teaching has helped me grow in my faith and advance in my career. The best part is, I'm saving money and I still have time for my family. I can't wait to see what happens next. Apply now to SAGU Online and see where a degree can take you.
We are champions of character. see injustice everywhere, you feel compelled to help others, to make a difference. But how? The answer is simple. By being exactly who you are. Now it is time to be equipped. Invoke change. Restore hope, peace, justice, and kindness. Turn your passion into compassion.
All right, we're back live in the Schaefer Center. And the Lions get first possession of the second half. Had a really good shooting outing, Steve, in the first half. They scored 50 points.
I'd say so. 50 points in any half is a good half.
But I think we both had the same kind of sentiment. Like, you're only up 11 as good as you shot. That's saying some good things about OPSU and just hanging in there, kind of weathering the storm, because it feels like they should be down 20-21, yep. Something like that. Good opener, great shot by C.J. Hall to start things off. Always want to start the first 5 minutes of the second half as well as you can. And Diaby comes in, and he's had a really good game.
Oh, dangerous pass there. All able to wrangle that in. And it looks like Yabby's going to be okay there.
Yep.
Kind of got run to the bench there.
He gets another foul. Might be his third.
Larry Call, Noah. Back to JJ, down to Cortland on the block. Back out to JJ. Nice rhythm shot. Beautiful. Really nice. In the flow of the offense. Inside, outside. Double screen there.
Nice move. Just
strong,
a little too much
move.
On it.
Yeah, just a little strong. Alaric Hall on the floor. Up to Noah Bowling. JJ got trapped under the basket a little bit.
If you had just looked up for a split second, you saw he actually had the right side of the glass wide open.
Oh, Alaric Hall. Nice crossover. Oh, great block.
That's why you need that teardrop.
Yeah, that's where you use it right there.
You go in there, you burn past the first layer, and then all of a sudden you're in the redwood trees. Oh, boy.
No Bowling with first personal there sends Taki Chivas to the line for two.
Chivas done some really good things for his team in the first half. Only had 5 points, but was just real active on defense. Stirring things up, you know, getting loose balls and tipping, gamble passes away, and just doing a really solid job.
Missed both of them there.
Oh, nice turn.
Didn't really have to pump fake there. I'd like to see him just go straight up. Thought he had a clean look of the bucket, but decides to a little pump fake.
Yeah, good hard effort.
Yeah.
Going to result in a foul, but that's a great swim move to get out and get his hand on the ball.
That's a quick move. Great defense there by Blake. Trapped, forced him to give the ball up. Turnover there. Lions on the move here.
The speed of C.J. Hall just accelerates. And he tried to get it to J.J. Bowling. It was a little late. Bowling couldn't handle it. Should have handled it.
A little late, a little hot there. Maybe a little bit,
but still, you got to be ready. Just got to be ready all times. And
it's probably one where he thought his teammates were going to go up for the shot. And
yeah.
Wasn't really prepared to catch it, but, yeah, you're right.
It was just a little bit out of sync, I think, at that point. But the rule of thumb is once you commit into the paint, you just take it yourself. It, I mean, unless your guy is just, you know, wide open, no defender there. But no one left, so
yeah.
Just go ahead and take it.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
I think I got J.J. Bowling there for the foul. Send Diaby back to the line. Seems like he has lived at the free throw line tonight. Misses one there. Got all the OPSU guys back on defense. Nobody there for the rebound, so they're gonna concede the rebound or the basket. And he makes that one. '55-'42, Sagu up on the Aggies. Early second half action here in the Schaefer Center.
Like it. What a great play design by Coach Dill. Are they? Oh wow. They're going to count the hop. So he hopped into it right there. See? And they're going to, they counted that first hop as a first step. It did look a little awkward. I think he ricocheted that off of a Sagu player. Short.
Oh, man. Take about Padmore. Wrestled the ball away from C.J. Hall.
Padmore did such a great job getting the rebound and a nice pass. And Greaves. Still very active. Aggies being very, very active. Maybe even out-activing the Lions. And just getting real busy, getting your hands in the mix, touching the ball a lot. Their problem has been on conversion. So just it's tough when the ball doesn't go in the bucket.
Yep.
And we saw that with the girls in the girls game. Ran the plays, very disciplined at running plays and being active, just can't convert. And ultimately, you got to find a way, and that's kind of what separates everybody, I guess. Just got to figure out how to get that ball in the back.
Yeah, you can't,
in the bucket.
Win games without that, for sure.
Yep.
Still but keeping it close, though.
But the defense has been really nice. And just kind of nagging and then still active on the offensive glass, going after loose possessions and going to hang in there.
And they are. Yeah,
and you just never know. Can you catch fire at the right time? If you can get, knock down three threes, bro, you just change the game and the whole complexion. Oh, nice move by J.J. Bowling. He saw that he was going to be open. Diaby gets
Diaby
the rebound.
With the rebound. J.J. able to hold off from that foul. That's good.
Diaby's got 16 points and 6 rebounds. He's doing a lot of work.
Diaby on the block. Strong move.
He knew. He had J.J. Bowling exactly where he wanted him. Either he was going to get a foul or the bucket. Hoping for both.
No on the right wing here. Decided to take it to the hole.
It's just being
contacts.
Quicker. Yep. Late call, but it's the right call. A lot of contact as Noah Bowling goes up.
I liked it there. J.J. was able to pull his guys on the block, pulls his guy off the block, gives a wide open lane there for Noah to take it to the hole. And draws contact there, goes to the line now. 2 shots for Noah Bowling. Good offensive possession there. See if he can knock these down.
He's a good free throw
shooter.
Great
free throw shooter. Got the shooter's roll there. He's got a great release, great rotation on the ball.
Best free throw shooter on the team, for sure. And if you're the opponent, you're definitely not the guy you want to foul at the end.
You can always tell it's good shooters to have a good rotation where that it just grabs the rim and just that rim just hangs on to that from the rotation and Shooters get that shooter roll. No need for the roll there. Drops it straight in. Noah Bowling was able to convert there. Two free throws. Padmore with ball side screen.
I'm going to say CJ Hall bumped him coming off there, right there, yeah. Yeah, I mean, offensive guy, the offensive player is always going to have, and when you're attacking, you're going to have the advantage.
Into the game for the Aggies, Bison, number zero, Bison Miller.
Oh, I like this matchup between Justin Collins and Diaby. Collins gives up maybe an inch and a half, but the physique, the build's the same, the weight's about the same. So that's just going to be a really good slugfest if you can keep your eye on that matchup. Diaby,
man,
doing what he's got to do.
Averaging just over 10 a game for Diaby, and tonight
this will be 19. 20, I believe. And he gets
it. Yeah, having a great game. Collins running the offense. Owens trying to get position. Roy really fighting down there. Ball screen for Collins. Five on the shot clock.
Not the desperation shot. Oh,
boy, that looked like it was going in. Aggies with the rebound.
CJ Hall, good defense. Tipping it out, slowing it down just a little bit. Trace Bowling comes in.
Have a big body, they can get a rebound, but can also shoot the three. To Brown.
They got a little bit of a mismatch bringing Colin Owens out, and I think Coach Belt would like to see some way to exploit that.
Yeah.
Yeah, faster guy on a bigger, slower guy. Oh, this is nice.
With a little heads-up play there. Got the ball in quick. Caught the defense off guard. Really nice there. Push the pace, didn't let them get into their defensive set. Easy layup there for the Lions. Y'all be asking for it at the high post. Yeah, Diaby Owens, that's a nice matchup there.
Oh, my.
Oh, wow.
Diaby.
Wow.
Skying over everybody.
Uh-oh, he's hobbling. I don't know if he came down wrong on an ankle. Walking really gingerly on the ankle. Still asking for the ball, trying to tough it out here. Or is it a shoe? I can't tell there.
No, his looks like his knee's wobbling just a little bit. Might have landed on it. Kind of awkwardly.
Well, he got up so high. Yeah, he's
kind of grimacing.
Oh, nice take there.
Now they get it under 10.
Man, Brown, strong move to the basket.
So Coach Dill's going back to the well. Get Cortland Blake back in the game. Try to get him offensively active. Oh, nice Collins. Move. Collins, I don't think he realized he lost his player.
Woo.
And J.J. Bowling pouring it on.
Really? Well, they desperately needed that three. And the Aggies going to get a timeout here, full timeout.
Full timeout. Like. Coach Belt said, hey, look, we cut this thing under 10. Now, we got to clean up a couple of things. Can't just give possessions away here. So there were three possessions already in the last 3 minutes where OPSU just gave it away. Like, slipped through the hands, went out, just not taking care of the ball, and they didn't even get an opportunity to score. Who knows if you would have gotten it to go in or not, but you at least got to get that attempt on the board. And then you know, but, you know, if you don't take care of the ball and you turn it over, well, that's a good way to lose a ball game.
Well, Diaby seemed to be hurt there, not sure the severity of the injury, but he's your best player on the floor right now, and if he has to go out, now you're wondering where are they going to go for to find offense.
Yeah.
And be interesting to see. Hopefully he's okay, but he was walking, running a little ginger on the knee, the ankle, some sort of lower body injury. But he has been the spark tonight for the Aggies for sure. See what they come out with on the floor. Coach Steele going with both Owens and Blake on the floor. Two big bodies for the Lions.
This is a really big lineup with Trace Bowling and
Trace Bowling. Oh,
Justin
man.
Collins out there. You only got one small. So Pat Moore likes his chances. He gets the
bucket and the foul call.
And I was going to say, when you were talking about
Diaby
maybe suffering injury, where's the points going to come from? It's Pat Moore. I think Pat Moore is really the next guy up that can really get some things done down in the paint. He's just going to have to step up and be strong, just like he showed right there.
Portland picking up where he left off in the first half. Nothing but
that's five. That's 5 3-pointers for Cortland. And
he is feeling it tonight. Well, if you coach Deal, you love seeing that. Coming down to the end of the season, best player.
Got 26 points.
Larrick Hall with the pressure up top. Padmore slips. Oh.
Cheap call there.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to say Colin Owens pushed him. I don't know. Yeah, I mean, he had it. Okay. I can see why. Yep. Yeah, had the full forearm. He's a big dude. I mean, it doesn't take much. So.
Seven fouls now for the Lions. Gonna put the Aggies on the line now.
We're going to get a little bit – well, no, we're going to trade some size. Maybe give up an inch here and bring in Noah Yonker.
12 minutes left to go in the second half here in the Schaefer Center. The Lions are already in the bonus. Let's see if that means anything coming down the stretch. Oh, nice quick move.
Yeah, they're going to call it a travel.
Yep, sure did.
It was more like a carry. Watch that off that dribble right there. He gets under it, but. Working it around. Trying to find something. You don't have your leading scorer on the floor. Oh, they're going to say Yonker touched it.
Nine seconds to shoot on the shot clock. Aggies ball on the baseline. Brown up top, got two to shoot. Let's go.
Oh, it goes in. awkward little kind of fadeaway
pump, double pump.
Yeah, he kicks his feet out at the end of his shot, so it does look like a double pump. And they're going to ring up, I believe, Padmore.
I'll get it on Brown. Brown on
the reach.
Going to send Trace Bowen on the line for two. Still a 10-point game here. Well, the Aggies are hanging around. Just about 11 minutes to play here. And Trace just in and out. Oh, misses both of them there. Aggies pushing the ball up the floor. Blake with rebound. Blair Call pushing the fast break here in the transition. Back to Hall.
Hall. Using the speed.
Yep. Yeah, that's what he does best. So fast.
Fast. In the video games, there's a boost that you can hit. Like in NBA Jams, there's this like little boost. He's got it. He's got that button somehow.
Padmore.
It's like a nitrous oxide boost.
Yeah. Oh, man. Lions come right back down to Blake on the block. Nice feed. Brown up top. Screen by Padmore. Collins on him. Padmore steps out. Ball side screen rolling the bucket. They got get Padmore for the moving screen there. That's a good call.
Not trying to project any. Okay, now there we go. I was going to say, I do not see Diaby over on the bench. And now he's in the game.
He's back in the game.
So good to see that.
Great to see. Blair Call off the screen. Into the corner for Trace. Oh, nice. Yeah.
Trace Bowling is an excellent range shooter.
Great assist there, too.
Yeah, his by far his strongest asset in his tool bag. So when you leave him wide open, man, that is dangerous proposition.
Yabby puts the ball on the floor. Oh, nice tip.
Great defense. Yep, Noah Yonker staying in front. Hands up.
Yeah. Too much contact. Number one, Jones. Just was trying to.
Yeah, he got sucked into the crossover.
Yeah.
And Larry Call. He can do that to guys. Yeah. He can put you right on skates, get you wobbling. And you kind of, the little tip, you want to know how to guard a Larry Hall, is kind of stay still. Let him do his thing, and then watch for his commit foot.
Yonker, pure shot there from three. Oh, man.
Chivas.
Chivas with his own three, answer back.
And they're going to need to see a little more of that from Chivas and Padmore. Brown, I mean, if they could just step it up another notch, just one more notch, each one of them, and really become knockdown shooters, these guys are going to be a big threat.
Sagu extending that lead just a little bit. Up 15 now. Still a lot of basketball left to play. Trying to get a little breathing room here. They're called to bring it up. Kind of been going to this screen and roll here with.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, yeah.
It's just not fair.
Oh, man. Wow.
Yeah. I think that was a travel.
I think Coach has seen a mismatch there. Alaric Hall, Cortland Blake. Little screen and roll action up top. Seems to
Cortland's
be working really well.
Cortland's had a couple of those that have just they're little bunnies that have not gone.
Into Yonker. Collins top of the key. Back to Alaric Hall. And it's put on the floor. It's like too much contact.
So both teams in the bonus. The on the floor, it's going to be a one-on-one scenario here.
A little short. Yeah, that didn't look right coming off of his hand. Yeah, I'll be back in the game. Nice defense, nice trap there by Collins, forced the ball out of his hands. Miller now guarded by Trace Bowling. Wanted to go to the floor. Oh man, tough hard screen there by Cortland Blake.
Nice entry pass.
Yes, great way to use his body.
And the tougher the shot is, the higher the percentage for Cortland Blake.
Yeah.
And when it's the easy bunnies, he struggles with it. But give him a tough scenario, he gets it. Playing up there around the rim is Greaves.
Greaves got up on that one. Blake going to the other side now. Left screen. Trace Bowling on the wing. Blake trying to get out of the way there. Oh, nice. When you have to go ball side and pull up, same side to shoot it. He made that look easy, but that wasn't easy.
Yeah. That's a little backyard right there. That's a little backyard. He's very comfortable backyard, you can tell. Lots of confidence makes that ball go in.
Yeah.
Nice. That's a defense. Good drop.
That's Bison Miller from downtown. Gets the Aggies to within 14. Collins run the defense now. Cortland Blake finds Yonker. Can't quite get that one to go from downtown. Aggies with the rebound. Right by Yonker trying to force him to go left. Looks like there might be a good scouting report there. Force him to have it offhand.
Chivas. Like to see him do that attack a lot more. So.
Full time out here.
You're going to get a swap out. The brothers Bowling are coming in. And I think Trace Bowling goes out. And probably Cortland Blake out. So you're going to keep Yonker in and Larrick and Justin Collins. Very interesting five here. This is a quick five. Other than Noah Yonker, you know, you got tremendous speed, and then you're going to use the size of Yonker to hopefully kind of guard the paint area and give Cortland just a little bit of a breather. So a lot of three-point prowess.
Yeah.
On this five coming out.
Yeah, they definitely have a lot of firepower on the floor. And they all have no problem shooting. And shooting really well as a team from beyond the arc tonight.
Maybe the weakest of the three-point shooters is Collins. I'll settle for that.
Yep.
Because what he will do is make that up in his attack game.
Yonker trying to get big on the block there.
And so will Alaric Hall.
Back out to Alaric Hall. Thought about shooting. Said nope.
The idea, but, man, you're talking about having to thread a very skinny eye of the needle.
Five to shoot on the shot clock. Lions inbounds from the sideline. Larry Call, quick move to the baseline.
Loses it. Yeah, just lost it.
And not a great possession there, but.
And right now, I think Coach is just trying to buy his bigs some breathing time,
yeah,
just in case. I mean, 1-3 cuts this thing to 9.
Yeah, Brown up top.
A little indecision by Padmore. Now he's backing down.
Oh.
Yep.
Yep, we're going to get him.
And Kyle's like, well, what did I do? You got your hand in the cookie jar. And even though you may have gotten 99% of the ball, your hand was in the cookie jar.
Well, when you have to pull them out that fast, too, you know, it's just an automatic signal. And ref's like, nah. When I see that, it's almost automatic blow the whistle.
Yep.
Padmore to the line now.
And he's just left a lot of points on the table due to a poor free throw shooting night.
Mello bowling on the penetration.
Back-to-back possessions, not getting an attempt.
Coach Deal probably not going to be happy with that. Nice take, good defense. Collins forcing him to, tough
wheeled
shot.
Wheeled that one in, man. Just wheeled.
Really, really nice.
Chivas. Got his willpower wheel going. I like that J.J. Bowling realized, okay, wait a minute. I probably need to step up. Like, he is the ultimate role player and utilitarian, but he recognized that, okay, I need to go and get this bucket. That's going to be a travel. Oh, no, they're going to call a foul.
Got him on Padmore, I think. See the replay here. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Yep,
they're going to get Padmore with the body there. It's two on Padmore. Noah will shoot the 1-1 here for the Lions, 81-69, just over 4 minutes to play. Coach still bringing Cortland Blake back in the game and C.J. Hall. There's that shooter's roll again. Noah gets that. It's the first one there to go.
Well, as college basketball age goes, Noah is considered to be a geriatric. So for the old school crowd watching, we call that a Geritol shot. You have a little too much Geritol in your shot. It means Geritol, for the youngsters that don't know, Geritol was a over-the-counter pill that you would take to induce iron into your bloodstream. And when you hit that much iron, you've been taking too much Geritol.
Oh, wow.
It bounced off of Chivas. Luckily.
That was a fortuitous bounce there. Oh, man. Greaves from the corner. This is an 11-point game. Maybe a little too close to cover. Oh, great pass from C.J. Hall to J.J.
Brown lost that assignment.
He
got stuck looking at Alaric Hall. And
about the time he found his guy.
Coach Belt, none too happy about that. Just going all the way. Yep. Chivas is – I think if he commits to this style of play and just commits, he took on a double team right there. And he will find himself getting on the line a lot.
Strong, too, you can tell.
Yeah, he's just –
really strong.
He's a great athlete, can move. I think there's just some things that he's got to find in the game part and how the game works for him. And once he really realizes how to match up his talent with his strategy, he's going to be a good player. So three timeouts left for the Aggies and two timeouts left for Sagu. Coach Belt, just getting his team to believe.
Yep.
And at this point, you know, you've been down the whole game. You know, can you still dig deep and believe that you can? That's what it'll take. You just got to knock down shots now.
Yeah, you're at the point in the game. Oh, excuse me.
All right. They're going, yeah, okay. I was going to say we left on a timeout to shoot free throws, and the Aggies are electing not to line up on the blocks and let Chivas shoot these by himself. Rattles one in. That'll be Chivas' 13th point.
Padmore's going to come back in the game for the Aggies. Sagu up 85-74. No ball in penetration. Cortland Blake on the block there. Nice kick back out. Oh, man.
Got up high, Greaves.
Golly, Greaves can really jump.
And that's going to be a full timeout from Coach Belt. And he sees an opportunity. Right here. Okay, we gotta steal on the possession here, so we gotta make this one count. We're down 11, so we can get it under double digits. And at that point, you're looking at 3 to 4 possession game, and much more manageable, especially mentally. You're in that 3 minute zone, a little under 3 minutes left in the game, and it's still doable. So. And he's got two timeouts left.
Well, if you're Coach Deal, you've got your best player on the floor in Cortland Blake, and he's been hot tonight. Also been just a monster down on the block and on the boards. And
I think he's going to have to squeeze C.J. Hall back in just to get a little more offensive power. And, yep.
I think here you're.
And now you got your starting five.
Yeah. So, Coach, going back with, going back with the starting five.
So, everybody should, you know, remotely, the thought is you're fresh. This is where, you know, 5 minutes ago and you had kind of a bench group out there buying time. And you buy it for these last 3 minutes.
Yes, this is exactly what he did that for. Good strategy. They're fresh for this last little stretch here.
Oh, that's a great backdoor.
Great backdoor cut.
No, I was going to say there was no foul. But there was a foul.
Wow, that was a really well-designed play.
Clean. Yep. And they're going to just leave it on the shooters to hit these. It's a 10-point ball game.
I mean, it's best-case scenario for the Aggies. Clock stopped. Still able to score from the free throw line. And he knocks them both. Got the lead under double digits. Only down 9 now. 2:45 left to go. See if Sagu has enough patience here and offensively to work that clock. The Lions, the clock is your friend. Good patience. Very nice discipline. Oh, man.
Are you kidding me?
How you do it.
Are you kidding me? Like, late in the game is it's like the beginning of the game.
7 for 9 for Courtland Blake.
What do you do?
From beyond the arc.
Yeah, I mean, he's just so dangerous. The closeout was nice. It wasn't uncontested. He just shot through it.
Well, what's interesting is he's hit a lot.
Watch,
from
the closeout's distracting. A big...
Man, big
like
boost.
That, being able to get rid of the ball that quickly, that is tremendous asset for Coach Dill. Now, that is Courtland Blake's 33rd point. He's got 9 rebounds, 1 rebound away from a double-double. J.J. Bowling, I believe, is 1 rebound away from a double-double. So some guys out there putting in a lot of work. And still some, you know, I mean, was that the nail in the coffin right there, you know? I know there's a lot of time,
I think psychologically it feels
yeah,
like
that's a dagger.
Yeah. Yeah, you've made a run. You got it under double digits. You think
you
got
hope. Yeah,
you
did what you wanted to do, and then all of a sudden,
and then it's just,
you know, you close out nicely, and you – just big players make big plays. Yep.
Brown up top now. Tried to go to that same play.
Well, they're running,
the back
yeah,
door.
They're running the play, and now they're back to static. Got to get more movement.
Ooh, dangerous pass there.
Greaves. Couldn't get it to go. No, it's 2 minutes, under 2 minutes.
So you're going to be patient here. Just running the offense. Moving the ball around the perimeter. In no hurry to score here. Little body got away with one there. Oh, man.
Good pass.
That's
from
great.
Noah Bowling.
Excellent offensive possession right there. You work the clock all the way down. Get a nice assist and the easy layup. A little push there. Uh-oh. Diaby hobbling on that knee again.
Diaby fouls out. A good night, 22 points, yeah. 8 rebounds. You know, he really wasn't as effective offensively after he got shaken up. Yeah. I think that was about the 10 to 8 minute mark. And he was really pouring it on and doing a lot of great offensive things. The other players on the team stepped up and started doing some good things, but you needed a full collected effort from everyone, really. And just a little too short. I think these guys are going to be good in the future. I think maybe 1 or 2 pieces away for Coach Belt. But the drastic improvement between the last time they played Sagu and this time, hats off, Coach Belt. You're making a dent with this young squad.
J.J. Bowling steal.
And just getting tired. And it's late. Like, the pressure's high, and you're starting to make the little mistakes.
Well, Coach Deal and the Lions, you know, you get a win any way you can.
Yep.
And that's the important thing. Take care of business on your home court. And tonight they've done that. Valiant effort by the Aggies. They took them to the wire.
Yep.
You know, it's only really in the last couple minutes here where Segu's kind of pulled away just enough where it's out of reach for the Aggies.
Yep.
But
Well, under 3 minutes, you know, they cut it under double digits, which was, I think, a goal for Coach Milt. He was like, okay, let's do this. He called a couple of timeouts. They strategically did what they needed to do. It's in there. It's in there. The engine is capable of running well. Just got to get a little more out of it.
And now under a minute to go for the Lions.
Hey, that's what you
try
do.
Try to cap it off with an exclamation point there.
You can't
they
let
were
that
not
happen.
Gonna let.
No, you can't let that happen. That was a good play by Chivas.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of people that say, you know, oh, why not just let him go? Well, no, that's your pride. You got to play with some pride out here. Even though you're getting beat, you're not going to let people rub salt in the wound.
Yeah.
I like it.
It's a hard foul. It's part of the game, you know.
I mean, it wasn't malicious.
Yeah, it wasn't malicious at all.
It's just like you're not going to dunk.
You're not going to dunk on me.
If you score, it's not going to be a dunk.
JJ knocks that second one down.
Yeah, I think this team just needs a little more of that knockdown shooter, you know. Somebody that is their job.
Yeah.
Step out perimeter and, you know, give me 3 to 4 a game. They're just going to be content with letting this run off. I mean, it's basically just a couple seconds between shot clock and good concession.
Yep.
Kind of the way it goes. So one more tap of the inbound play here. Maybe give him a chance to earn a smoothie for a year, man. Right here, half court shot. Like to see it. All right.
Yeah, that would be it.
And that is your ball game.
Double zeros on the clock.
Only one more left, and it's going to be a big one. It's senior day. It is a must win for Sagu. Just to take in some momentum to the postseason. And Wayland Baptist coming to town. It's a good rivalry.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of people in the house.
Yes.
A lot of viewers
game.
Online. I mean, it is just going to be an all-out brawl on Saturday. You're not going to want to miss that at all. I can't tell you. Like, I can't overstate it enough. It is going to be a fun broadcast. And we're going to have sitting in with us for a little while Sagu Lions' new head football coach. That's very exciting.
All right.
I can't wait. The Hudge. Coach.
Hudgens?
Yeah. Coach Jared Hudgens. Oh, he's good. One of my favorite people in the world.
He's a good dude.
He is just an amazing guy. Was an amazing football player. Just an all-world linebacker that has come up through the ranks. Now he's back at his alma mater to be the head coach. And I'm very excited to get him on the mic and just to see how things are going and what we can look forward to in this new fall season of football. And, you know, football's big here in Texas.
Yes, it is.
If you didn't know. It's going to be. And there's some live game look-ins, a little bit of the rest of the Sooner Athletic Conference. I don't think we can see the MacU game, which looks interesting. Looks interesting. MacU came here last week and stole one from the Lions. And they're a very good team, but Oklahoma City just making some noise here at the end. They had such a bad start, and I knew they had some talent over there. And, they're showing it coming down this home stretch, but they don't have any shot for postseason hopes, so they just got to do it over the next couple games. And if they could get a win there in MacU, that's going to mean a lot for next year. So that's going to be a barn burner right there, Langston, Texas Wesleyan.
Wow.
How about that over in Fort Worth?
Making some noise.
Kind of wish I could be over there just to watch it live. Another one. Texas Wesleyan had a bad start, and then they've just come on here late in the season and done big things. That looks like it's going back and forth. You want to keep your eye out. And you can watch that. Get those games on the Sooner Athletic Digital Network. Wow. Texas, I'm getting into the game. I'm watching the game. But we're going to have to kick it out. Make sure you join us on Saturday. If you can't be here, we'll see you on the tube, on the YouTube or the Facebook or, wherever you decide to watch. And we'll be here for you. But it's been a great night of basketball. Two wins over Oklahoma Panhandle State University for the men and the women. Trying to do big things. All right. I'm John Cookman and Steve Fiedler, my partner in rhyme and crime. It has been a blast.
Been fun tonight, John. Some great basketball. Looking forward to Saturday night.
All right. We'll see you next time. You've been watching the Sagu Sports Network.